Where's the stand rack? Where's the stand rack? Somebody get the stand rack. Lift it up. Two chairs. Leave that one stand in the middle. That's the conductor's stand. Leave it out. One chair. Put that chair back. Then grab the stool to the piano. Bring it dead center. Grab the stool to the piano. Leave that there. Leave it on the piano there. Okay, grab the stool, bring it dead center. Let's go. Take the chairs and put them into Mr. Hayes' room. guys are about a foot forward. Get in the middle, somebody get in the middle, and in the end, Benna, get in the end. Push forward. Get in. Alright, okay. That's good push. So Mr. Has a mic, has a stand. Piano may need to move, I don't know what he's doing with it. Tell him he's ready.
Yeah. mixed group of 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th graders who are in the conservatory, as well as some 9th and 10th graders who just love to sing choral music, so they're in this group as well. We meet every day for 45 minutes, and for this concert we have prepared three pieces, all from the continent of Africa. The first one was, you probably recognize, Hakuna Matata. This was a pop song in Kenya. It was all about coming to see Kenya in the 1980s. But Elton John actually heard that and stole the Hakuna Matata part for his 1994 Lion King song. Our next piece is a traditional African-American spiritual with a theme that is actually Ethiopian. And our last piece in this set is Anya Ngena, which is from South Africa, and it's in the Zulu language.
Over me, my Lord, all night.
our select choir. These students are either in the conservatory or previously in the music conservatory. They are mostly 11th and 12th graders. I think we have two 10th graders in here. This group has been hard at work this year. You're going to hear six different pieces from them tonight. I'm going to just announce all six to you now, and then I'll step off. They're an a cappella group who will conduct themselves. They know what they're doing. I'll start with our second piece, which is a pop piece from the 1960s, Happy Together. Followed by that is a 1970s pop piece called The Lonesome Road. And then we have a piece from the 50s, but it's the 1550s. It was popular in its time, so I guess you could call that pop music. It's Secret Cherbus, which is sort of the ideal of a Renaissance counterpoint music by Palestrina. And after that, we're going to do sort of an unusual choice, you might think, but it's White Christmas. And we're doing that because, as I said, this group has been busy. In the first 12 weeks of school, they have learned and just about memorized 27 a cappella four-part Christmas songs to go out and perform. They have full costumes, Charles Dickens outfits. They look adorable, they sound fantastic. Of course, I'm very proud because I help make the costumes. But not all by myself, Mrs. Taylor's out here somewhere. She did a huge amount, and so did Mrs. Williams, who made our bonnets. So if you get a chance, please come hear us this year. I will also let you know that you can book us. We would love to come and perform at your party, and donations are gladly accepted. So tonight, rather than 27 Christmas songs, they'll just do one, White Christmas. And then the last piece we'll do for you tonight is something we learned last week, and it was for Montverde's Veterans Day, which we just did this past Sunday, and that is the Battle Hymn of the Republic. So without further, oh, I'm sorry, there is further ado. The first piece they are going to perform again tomorrow night. It is for the magic game that'll be happening in downtown Orlando. I think they're singing at 7 o'clock. So I would like you please all to rise for the singing of our national anthem.
Skies will be blue. happy together.
Ba 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 ba.
Me and you and me, no matter how they toss the dice, it had to be the only one for me is you and you for me. So happy together.
Happy together.
Lightning of his terrible swift sword, his truth is marching on.